स्टार्ट करें सर।
गुड इवनिंग टू ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वुड लाइक टू वेलकम यू ऑल इन दिस वेबकास्ट ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय इस स्टूडेंट स्किल एनरिचमेंट बोर्ड, बोर्ड ऑफ स्टडीज ऑपरेशंस ऑफ आईसीआई। आई एम थैंकफुल टू सीए अतुल कुमार गुप्ता, प्रेसिडेंट आईसीआई, सीए निहार जम्बूसरिया जी, वाइस प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ आईसीआई, सीए जय छायरा, चेयरमैन ऑफ स्टूडेंट स्किल एनरिचमेंट बोर्ड, सीए प्रमोद कुमार बुक, वाइस चेयरमैन ऑफ स्टूडेंट स्किल एनरिचमेंट बोर्ड, कोऑर्डिनेटर्स ऑफ दिस स्टूडेंट स्किल एनरिचमेंट प्रोग्राम सीए धीरज शर्मा, चेयरमैन गुड़गांव ब्रांच ऑफ एनआईआरटी ऑफ आईसीआई, सीए सुनील मोर एंड सीए दिव्या चंद्रा, चेयरमैन ऑफ प्रयागराज ब्रांच एंड मॉडरेटर टू दिस सेशन। नाउ वी आर मूविंग टू प्रेजेंटेशन फॉर द डे। आई एम जस्ट शेयरिंग माई स्क्रीन टू पुट प्रेजेंटेशन शेयरिंग विद यू। तो आवर टॉपिक फॉर टुडे इज इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ आवर आर्टिकलशिप एंड इंडस्ट्रियल ट्रेनिंग। तो टुडे वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग द फॉलोइंग थिंग। फर्स्ट इज द ब्रीफ अबाउट आर्टिकलशिप एंड इंडस्ट्रियल ट्रेनिंग, देन व्हाई डू यू नीड प्रैक्टिकल ट्रेनिंग, देन इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ आर्टिकलशिप एंड इंडस्ट्रियल ट्रेनिंग विच हेल्प ए आर्टिकल ट्रेनी इन professional development as well as personal development, and then at the end best practices to be followed by an article assistant. So first of foremost thing, articleship and industrial training. So a chartered accountant is one such professional who has attained the CA certification by undergoing several level of examination starting from foundation, intermediate and final, and had served 3 years of articleship under a chartered accountant. So this articleship training is a real-time assignment with real-time employer, which are the chartered accountants. To start the articleship, you have few prerequisites, which are exams, orientation program organized by Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, and then only a student who meet all the criteria then can start their articleship. Apart from that, there is one more option available to the student, which is industrial training. It is part of articleship only for CA students. So CA students can apply to the various industries in last year of articleship, which we will discuss in the coming slide. So, industrial training, a CA student who can apply for the various industries in the last year of articleship. So, industrial training option is only available in the third year of articleship. Industrial training gives you great benefits and experience during your study, including you have first-hand experience working as a professional, apply for technical knowledge to the real-life solutions, experience what that take work in a professional organization, how practically the professional organizations work, introduce you to the industry norms, witness the functioning and organization of a business and companies. All these items we will be discussing in further slides in detail. There are many more benefits to the industrial training, which we will be discussing in our further slides. Moving next, this is the list of the industries for which you can apply for your industrial training is available on ICAI website. I have put the screenshot over here. You can see on the ICAI website, if you go to the student section and then practical training and industrial training, then you will find the list of industries approved for undergoing the industrial training. In this link, you will find all the industries, their contact details to whom you can reach out for your industrial training. You can apply for industrial training. एंड दिस इज एक एग्जॉस्टिव लिस्ट. ऑल द एलिजिबल इंडस्ट्रीज आर अवेलेबल ऑन दिस लिंक. यू कैन गो एंड रीच आउट टू देम ऑल द एम्प्लॉयर्स एंड फाइंड द डिटेल्स ओवर हियर. So why do we need a practical training? So ICAI, when designed their course from initially, the course has been designed in a way that it gives you a practical and theoretical both the knowledges, because for a professional, it both the experience are required to succeed in their profession. So when it comes to knowledge, there are different kind of knowledge and different kind of ways to acquire each kind of them. So one portion is theory, which is the book knowledge, and another side is the practical application of theory. Being a professional, being a chartered accountant, it is very important for us to apply our theoretical knowledge in practical manner, because at the end, in our day-to-day life and working, we have to implement all the knowledge we have gained through our examination and the reading of the curriculum and the course. So we need to apply that to solve the problem of our clients, our industry, and our all the stakeholders. So both type of knowledge are important and both make you better at whatever you do. Theoretical or practical knowledge alone cannot make a perfect professional. So for each professional, he has to acquire both professional and practical knowledge. So to make it more elaborate, we take an example like swimming can never be learned by reading how to swim. One has to go to the pool and practically jump into the waters to learn swimming. Likewise, just writing the examination will fail you in the application of theory in the practice unless you have done the application practically. So it is very important for a successful professional to gain the theoretical knowledge and apply it practically at the same level. Both the skills are must-have skills, and the articleship is the best way to get your practical exposure, get the practical exposure from the work. So articleship is the golden time for a CA student, as it helps in professional development as well as personal development. Here are few conventional and some basic skill and qualities which we will be discussing that every article can learn during his articleship tenure. So there are various kind of things which we can learn practically during our articleship or the industrial training. So I, for this purpose of this session, I have divided all the skills into professional development skills and the personal development skills. So to start with, so professional development is bifurcated into the technical skills, which is accounting, auditing, taxation, management consultancy and other services, general business interest and awareness, organization skills, strong analytical and problem solving skills, ethics, technical updation and information and technology. So the students, you need to understand that articleship is your career launch pad. So once you go to the qualify the CA examination and become a chartered accountant, the expectation from society and all the stakeholders are very high. So to meet that expectation, you need to work hard during your articleship and learn a lot of things. So to start with, we will be discussing one by one all the professional development skills for professional development. The first is the accounting, which you learn during your articleship. So during your studies, you have learned what are the accounting entries are passed for what all kind of transactions, but these accounting entries are very basic. You need to learn what are the practical application of these accounting entries. So it can start with simple data entry that you are doing accounting for some of your client using some today everybody is using some kind of software for all these accounting systems. So it might be Tally, it might be some other accounting software which are used widely in the industry. SAP, Oracle are the advanced systems which are used by big industries. So the article during your accounting training, you can familiarize yourself with the basic accounting software, how these are used, and develop your accounting skills. So to make a balance sheet, the accounting entry is the basic transaction. So all the accounting entries are passed and trial balance is generated to prepare the financial statement. So once you do the accounting and once you reach to the level of reviewing balance sheet, you can relate how these transactions has been converted into the financial statement. So this is how the understanding the accounting, how it is done, selection of right ledgers, right head of account, all these things you can learn from your accounting training. So accounting audit is the next topic which we will be discussing. Auditing is the first and foremost thing which is all the chartered accountants are doing. So it is highly likely that the day you join your articleship, you will be sent out for your first phase of audit, which is vouching. So in vouching is the first and foremost thing you do as a practical application at your client side. So you need to understand how audit is conducted. Audit is a complete process which starts from planning, then execution and finalizing the audit. So the point here to know is developing a working knowledge of standard of audit, what all are the standard of auditing, and getting to know the history of accounting error and the system problems at a particular client. A client's place can easily benefit you in understanding how things done in real life. So when you practically do an audit at a client, you can start with reviewing their earlier year files, documentation available with your firm. So you learn about the client and then implement your knowledge at the client side. This is how you develop your auditing skill. Third is the taxation. Taxation is a great area of work for all the chartered accountants. So in taxation include both the direct taxation and indirect taxation. Currently direct taxation is Income Tax Act, and the indirect taxation is Goods and Service Tax Act, known as GST. So in taxation work, you start with computation of total income and tax liability in Income Tax Act, practically applying all the income tax provisions which you have learned during your curriculum. So with that, you will learn how the application of all these sections is done in the real life. Then applying, when preparing for the and filing the returns, which are income tax return, TDS return and all other returns, you know how all these returns are prepared, how the taxation is, TDS returns are prepared, how the interpretation is done for all the applicable tax rate, TDS rate. Then coming to next is the valuation of stock securities for the purpose of various direct tax laws, which includes there are multiple sections in the Income Tax Act and the indirect tax as well, where it requires valuation specific for the taxation purpose, which is generally or might different from the book stock valuation and the accounting stock valuation. Then text planning is a great area which you can learn during your articleship. How the text planning is done, what are the practical measures you have to take during your planning of your client's taxation. And then drafting of relevant deed, document and scheme, etc. So in various taxation, you need to prepare relevant deeds, documents, etc. So you learn preparing while your practical training. And then preparing and filing returns for the GST and custom and all other laws. So when you prepare your returns, you need to apply your theoretical knowledge into the practice, and you prepare and see how these relevant provisions are applied in real life. Then management consultancy and other services. So multiple services or bucket or services which is provided by a chartered accountant as a management consultant. These services generally include preparation of cash flow statement and forecast. So for all the funding requirement, their capital or working capital requirement, chartered accountants provide management consultancy services to their client, and as a part of their services, they prepare fund flow, cash flow statement and forecast. So all these things services are practically you learn how the fund flow or cash flow statements are prepared, how these statements are read, what are the practical implication of one aspect in that scenario. So what it means when you go and see how the cash flow works and how the forecasts are prepared. Then projection of working capital requirements. So somebody is doing his business, he is planning to expand his business. Then he need to see what how much capital or working capital he would be requiring and how this can be met. Then preparation and processing of loan application, then amalgamation and merger of companies, then planning of capital structure, drafting of MOA, memorandum and AOA of the company, and practically formulating a company, raising capital and raising new issues. So all these subjects are practical subjects which you can learn during your articleship. During your articleship or industrial training, you would be in constant touch with the real business world. So when you are working with your client, you are in the real world. It's not theoretical. So when you audit some client or you are doing accounting, then you understand the business, that what are the business, what are their operations, how the business processes run, what are their profitability margins, what are their general business trend, how in which industry the client is working, how the industry is running domestically and internationally. All these business senses you get, and you can develop your interest toward any specific industry, and you can learn more about industry while implementing your general knowledge into the practical aspects. We'll hold for a moment to have water. Yeah, sorry. So organization skills. So when you are going through your training, it is very important
हेलो
you acquire. Hello? Hello? organization abilities directly affect your ability to meet deadline and produce through high quality work. We need to understand when you are undergoing through your training, it's not only about what you are doing today. The training is for your preparation for tomorrow. So when you join an organization, a bigger organization, where you are working under some team and the team members are also reporting to you. So once you reach at a level, you need to acquire the organization skill as well. So you need to organize yourself and your team. So during your articleship, once you rise into the second year and third year of level, then articleship, you need to understand how to delegate the work, how decisions are taken, managing appointment and the team management. So when you are working in team, you need to understand what can work can be delegated to others. And the delegation is not just for completion of work, it is for development of their other team members and their learning opportunities as well. You need to manage your team as well, so you can be a better manager in the times to come. The next is the strong analytical and problem solving skills. So when you are doing theoretical or the book knowledge, the analytical things are very important for a financial consultant or a chartered accountant. We need to analyze the balance sheet and projection, everything very strongly. So this is a must-have skill in today's world, where everything is doing analytically. So you need to learn and make you analytical skill refer to the ability to collect and analyze information, solve the problem, make the decision. So in today's world, employees who possess the strength can help solve a company's problem and improve its overall productivity and success. Analytical skills might sound technical, but we can use these skills in everyday work. Analytical skill set are must have in case of CA students during the tenure of articleship. They can get professional qualification and develop analytical skills while working on practical examples. So when you are reviewing a balance sheet, you need to see how the ratios are done. So you can analytically see that when you are doing audit, you can perform analytical reviews on all the financial statement line items which you feel are relevant and can be performed by doing analytical analysis. Ethics is the strength or the base of our profession. So this is the first and foremost priority of chartered accountants to uphold their strong ethical standard. If any work a CA being offered against his values and ethics, he should not accept. During the tenure of articleship, a student learned that how he should apply his professional skepticism while accepting the work. So ethics are, just to share, ethics are confidentiality of sharing the client information. So when we maintaining the client confidentiality, so when you are working on a client, you have access to their financial information. Financial information is very key and very confidential information. You should not share any of information with your friends or family members or anybody else. Any information with your client's business, process or the financial information. So Maintaining ethics is very important for all the chartered accountants. So you learn from your seniors how they maintain the ethics, and you learn from them and apply in your practical life. Technical updation. So we are living in a world where everything is updated very rapidly. Everything is changing very rapidly. Every law has been amended very frequently. So we have to be updated in our technical knowledge. The CAs is known to be expert in multiple domain, accounting, auditing, corporate law, taxation, finance, etc., which means updating himself with the income tax is not enough. He is expected to know about IFRS, new standard of auditing, new provisions came into Companies Act and amendments thereto. Also know about the trending and profitable investment and the fluctuations in the market, economy, everything. So when you work practically, a student keep himself updated with the new and amended law, as well as keep an eye over new case laws as he is consistent touch with the real life work. So when you work practically, you are updated because you need to apply your knowledge into the practice. Information technology. In today's world, information technology is a great tool for every professional. Every profession demands you to adopt modern technology. As a simple example, today we are doing this webcast, live webcast. Otherwise, we used to do all these things in a seminar or a conference. But in today's world, we are using technology and sharing our knowledge through the technology. Every profession, so today, no one has time to wait for you to prepare his return with pen and paper. There are many taxation software which you can use. And apart from that, there are multiple things which can be used, the newer technology. There are multiple sources you can learn the technology, how to use technology practically for the professional things. Excel is a great tool or a software which you can learn during your articleship. Use of Excel is, and the advanced Excel is a must-have skill for all the CA students. Now we would be moving to the importance of articleship and how it helps in the personal development. So personal development is a major time saver. The better you become, the less time it takes to achieve your goals. So you have to improve your interpersonal skills as well to succeed in your profession. Not only professional development, the tenure of articleship also help a student in personal development. So we will be discussing few areas of personal development which you can work upon during your articleship, and you can learn practically how to improve on your interpersonal skills and become a better professional. So we will be discussing communication skills, the time management, teamwork, leadership skill, learning from others, public speaking, research orientation, discipline, diligence, and hard work, integrity, and trustworthiness. These are the must-have personal development skills, and we will be discussing one by one. Communication skills. I would be taking a break to have water. Thank you. So communication skills. When you are in a meeting, you should realize that person you are dealing with holds a vast amount of knowledge regarding his company. If you have a good query but your presentation is bad, he can outwit you easily. So the communication skills are the key. The message you convey should be communicated properly. So communication skills, we can say वन इज द ऑरल कम्युनिकेशन, अनदर इज द रिटन कम्युनिकेशन. इन ओरल कम्युनिकेशन हाउ डू यू कम्युनिकेट, वॉट आर द स्टेप्स यू टेक ड्यूरिंग योर वर्बल कम्युनिकेशन, हाउ डू यू ग्रीट वेन यू मीट समवन. वर्बल एंड नॉन वर्बल कम्युनिकेशन स्किल्स यू कैन लर्न फ्रॉम योर सीनियर्स, योर पार्टनर्स, योर चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट एंड द क्लाइंट एज वेल. सो यू नीड, वेन यू स्टार्ट कम्युनिकेटिंग विद पीपल, यू नो वॉट टू डू, वॉट नॉट टू डू. यू डोंट नीड नॉट ओनली लर्न वर्बल कम्युनिकेशन स्किल, यू अंडरस्टैंड वॉट आर द नॉन वर्बल कम्युनिकेशन स्किल्स एज वेल. So starting with the example, how to make a eye contact, when to laugh, when not to, how to react with someone's action, how to react on someone's reaction. All these things are part of your communication. These are the things which you can learn while communicating, while working on your clients and with your seniors. The CA student has great opportunity during his articleship, taking initiatives such as request your principal that he allows you to attend his meeting with client regarding audit, etc., can be helpful in developing communication skill while discussing audit related queries. So when you join your seniors, when they are discussing with their client, you learn how the questions are framed, how the questions are asked, and how we cross question. So all these are the communication skill you need to understand and learn during your articleship period. The written communication skills are also very important for the professionals. So it includes writing an email. So email writing is a separate topic, can be a full topic. It is start how to start a mail, when you put salutation, and then what should be the content, and how you close your queries. So you need to work upon your email writing skill, which is very important in the today's world. Time management. We are TA profession is a deadline based profession. We have deadline for all the compliances, and we apart from that, we also need to ensure timely completion of our professional work. So time management becomes a essential thing of our day-to-day life. Good time management allows you to accomplish more in shorter period of time, leads to more free time, which lets you take advantage of learning opportunities, lowering your stress, and helps you focus, which leads to more career success. Each benefit of time management improves another aspect of your life. Because of lot of tasks and the multi-tasking to be performed during the tenure of articleship, the student learned the time management, start prioritizing work, which work need to be done on the priority basis, which thing to be done first, and which can be deferred or can be completed at a later stage. And ensure effective time, use of time that allows you to plan your day in such a way that you finish your work with less effort. So time management is essential for each professional, and during your articleship with your multitasking, you can start learning time management, start prioritizing the work, and become a successful professional. Teamwork. So when you enter into the corporate world, teamwork is the must-have skill. Teamwork skills are essential for your success and the success of your organization where you work. Each employer looking for a person who has team, who can work with a team or the larger team. So no matter your industry or job title, working well with clients, colleagues, manager, and other people in your workplace can help you complete tasks efficiently while creating an enjoyable environment both for yourself and others. An organization is that empathizes good teamwork skill is typically a healthy, high functioning workplace. During your articleship, a student has to work with group of people to achieve a shared goal or outcome in the effective way. The student learns how to listen to another member, to the team, and taking everyone's idea on board, not just your own. So during your articleship, you learn how to help others, how to ask for help. When you are a junior team member, you take help from other or the senior team members. When you rise in the organization, you are becoming experienced article training. Then you help your junior team members in learning and completing their work. This is how you learn how the teams work and how the goal of a team is achieved. Leadership skill. So every professional has to have a leadership skill to rise in their careers. So during your articleship, you can develop your leadership skill, such as improved ability to succeed under pressure. So when deadlines are hard, hitting hard to us, and we have pressure of lot of work, then how to handle these pressure makes you a good leader. It's a leadership quality which you need to learn during your articleship. Growth in confidence, your team. So when you are working with team, you have to rely your team. You need to put your confidence into your team. Then improved listening and communication skill. As we have already discussed, you need to learn listening, improve your listening skill and the communication skill. Increased awareness of diversity in the workforce. Leadership can benefit every aspect of your life. It's not just about personal life, professional life. It helps you in personal life as well, giving you greater confidence, strengthening your communication and negotiation skill, and developing character. The values you learn as a leader can improve your personal life and relationship and set you on the fast track to success in your career and business life. So you, during your articleship, you can focus on growing your confidence, working with teams, improving your pressure handling situation. It will all help you in developing your leadership skills. Learning from others. So when we discuss about our CA curriculum, it is theoretical and practical knowledge. And the practical knowledge is gained from others. So everything you cannot learn at your own, during your articleship, you can learn from others, whoever knows it. So when you meet with your senior, your client, so whatever they know in your field or the domain you are working with, you can ask them for help. You can learn from others both directly and indirectly. Direct learning takes place when you ask people how they do something, listen to their answer, and try to imitate what they did. Indirect learning is when you observe someone doing something and imitate the procedure the person follows. So you have to focus on your learning through direct and indirect method. You also start observing people, how they are doing, how they are working on any platform, or how they are completing the task. You can observe and learn from others during your articleship. Public speaking. So to improve public skill during your article assistant, you should participate in student conference and seminar organized by ICAI. Article assistant should take initiative and perform on stage on topics included in conferences. So public speaking is a great fear, but you have to start. So during your articleship, you can take part in various initiative taken by the ICAI. So there are various kind of student conferences, seminars are organized by branch and other level at the institute level. You can participate and present yourself. To start with, you can start with your office group as well, and you can take benefit during your articleship period. Research orientation. Because our profession is knowledge-based profession. So we need to develop our research orientation. So during your articleship period, you can constantly more knowledge and implementing practically. Discipline, diligence, and hard work are the key to the success. Discipline is the bridge between goal and accomplishment. So you need to be very disciplined. You learn how to work in an organization, how diligent you should be towards your work, and you have to work hard during your tenure. So during your tenure of articleship, a student has to be self-disciplined by obeying rules or standard or behavior and code of conduct of the organization. Discipline brings stability and structure into a person's life. It teaches a student to be responsible and respectful. The well-defined rules is the base for the company is must. So you need to be very disciplined during your articleship period. You learn how the discipline helps in reaching your goals. Integrity and trustworthiness. Articleship give you a platform to act integrity. People will trust you and word will spread fast than any advertising campaign you can ever come up with. So when you work with people, the mouth publicity is a great tool. So you need to show your integrity, then only people will trust. Similarly, a lack of integrity will hurt your reputation. So acting with integrity will allow you reap the benefits from better relationship with the people you deal with. So during your articleship, you need to understand the importance of integrity and trustworthiness. Trustworthiness is the most important qualities in life. It is quality on which all relationships are built. So you need to understand our profession is the profession of trust. TAs are trustworthiness. So you need to show that trustiness, improve your personal skills, how to become trustiness with your clients, with your seniors, with your principals. All these things you become more trustworthiness. We are designed to be in relationship with others, and being able to trust each other means what we can do more together. These both qualities can be developed in the tenure of articleship, and it will help you in building a better personal and professional relationship with your clients and co-workers. So with this, we have completed our discussion around professional and personal skills which we can develop during our articleship. Now we will be moving toward the best practices which we should maintain or which a article assistant should follow during his articleship period. So we will be discussing following items, starting with attend complete training program or the training period. Follow code of conduct, not to engage any other occupation or profession. Learn effectively and maintain record of your learning. To start with, articleship period of 3 years is very well defined by the institute, and it is a through thought process that why the training should be of 3 years period. So I would like to make it in a way, present in a way that 3 years of articleship you can define first year as learning. The second year is the practical application, and third or the practice. So learning, practice, and third year as a live. So first you need to learn, then practice, and then live all these things you have learned during your articleship. So the you should complete your articleship diligently. You should not perform work during full tenure and should not go for leaves and other things. So our profession is कोड ऑफ कंडक्ट इज द की एंड द बेस ऑफ आर प्रोफेशन. सो इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट्स ऑफ इंडिया हैज ऑल्सो डिफाइंड कोड ऑफ कंडक्ट फॉर सीए स्टूडेंट एज वेल. सो वी आर डिस्कसिंग व्हाट ऑल द पॉइंट्स हैज बीन गिवन इन द कोड ऑफ कंडक्ट फॉर सीए स्टूडेंट. द आर्टिकल असिस्टेंट शैल एट ऑल द टाइम डिलीजेंटली एंड फेथफुली सर्व द प्रिंसिपल इन द प्रैक्टिस ऑफ प्रोफेशन ऑफ अकाउंटेंसी. सो एज वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड, यू हैव टू बी डिलीजेंट एंड फेथफुली सर्व योर प्रिंसिपल. द सेकेंड इज द आर्टिकल असिस्टेंट शैल फॉलो द कोवेनेंट कंटेंट इन द डीड ऑफ आर्टिकल एंड द प्रोविजन्स ऑफ द एक्ट एंड रेगुलेशन एज मे बी एप्लीकेबल फ्रॉम टाइम टू टाइम. सो ईच आर्टिकल एंड द एम्प्लॉयर हैज टू एंटर इन टू द डीड ऑफ आर्टिकल एंड इट्स प्रोविजन. इट हैज टू बी फॉलोड एंड वॉट एवर रेगुलेशन आर एप्लीकेबल टू ए सीए स्टूडेंट हैज टू बी फॉलोड एज दे आर एप्लीकेबल. द आर्टिकल असिस्टेंट शैल बी रिस्पॉन्सिबल for the quality and correctness of the work done by him in the course of practical training either in the office of principal or in the office of any of clients of the principal. So when you are working during your articleship, you has to ensure the quality of work done and the correctness. So if you have doubt, you should go to your seniors, your principals, your training in charge and ensure that the work done is as per quality standard. The article assistant shall not at any time during the continuation of his articleship destroy, cancel, obliterate, spoil, embezzle, spend, take away with him, oblique her, copies of books, papers, plan, document, money, the stamp, hardware, software or chattel whether belonging to the employer or his personal representative, assignees, partner, client, which came into his oblique her hands or custody or possession or allow any other person to use the same with prior approval of his employer. So it is very important when you are working, you have access to various documents and things, hardware, software and multiple items which are used in day-to-day life which may belong to your principal or their client. You should ensure that these are not used for any other reasons and anybody else without permission and prior approval from your employer. The article assistant should at all the times observe discipline and follow the guidelines, rules and regulations set out by his employer and not act in any manner that will bring disrepute to his employer or the profession in general. So every article assistant should have to be very disciplined, behave very diligently and follow all the rules, regulation and guidelines, because any of variation from all these things may disrepute his employer and the profession as well. So being the torchbearer of the profession, every article assistant should diligently work and should behave very disciplined and diligently. The article assistant shall obey and follow all lawful and reasonable instructions of his employer and shall not depart or absent himself from training of the employer at any time during the said term without the prior consent of his employer or partners, but shall at the time during the said term conduct himself with honesty and propriety. So again, discussing the completion of articleship, diligently serving the complete tenure, being disciplined, not denying and obeying all the rules and performing your training diligently is very important. Then article student shall behave in responsible manner as a proactive member of profession with the colleagues, staff members in the employer's office, clients, employers, clients and their representative, institutes, official and employees and judicial, quasi-judicial and other authorities. Wherever they or she represents his employer. So during your articleship, you meet with various people in the profession. So you meet with your colleagues, staff members, with your principal. You meet with client, their employees, and you meet with the institute's official and the employees. When you go to the various departments, you meet with the judicial or quasi-judicial authority. So whenever you represent, you should be very behave very responsibly. The article assistant shall conduct himself in a manner which shall show that he is endowed with impeccable character and help him to uphold ethical principle and professional code of ethics. As we have already said that base of our profession is code of ethics, and we have to follow our ethics during all the period of our articleship, during our professional and personal life. The article shall not obtain any monetary help or assistance or any form of gratification directly or indirectly from the client of the principal, their official or representative. You should be very mindful that you are not taking any kind of gratification in monetary or any other terms from any client, because it is against our code of conduct. Students, while undergoing article training, shall adhere to the formal dress code as per the local culture and tradition. Students, while undergoing orientation course, management and communication skill, MCS course, information technology advanced course, should remain disciplined, and decorum, apart from adhering to dress code, should be met. So the ICAI has given a code of conduct or have prescribed a dress code, so we should always follow the dress code in all the working hours and when joining any of the activity which are organized by the institute, which may be your orientation, management training, information technology, or any student seminar, etc. In all these things, we should strictly adhere to the institute guideline with respect to dressing code. So moving to the next point, which is not to engage in any other occupation. An article assistant cannot take up any other course of study or training, whether academic, professional, or engage in any business or occupation without prior permission of council. The permission may be granted to an article assistant for pursuing one additional course of study at a time during the period of his practical training on submission of request in prescribed form to the institute in form number 112, duly certified by principal. So you have to be very cautious when you are engaging in any other course during your articleship. You have to take prior permission from the council in the form defined by the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, and you should not engage yourself in any profession or vocation during your articleship period. So the whole purpose of articleship is the learning. So you need to understand that effective learning is key to the success. So to learn effectively, article assistant should focus on the following areas during his articleship. So the acquisition of adequate theoretical knowledge. First, you need to obtain the theoretical knowledge. Then developing skills in applying theoretical knowledge into practical. So once you have acquired theoretical knowledge, you need to understand and develop the skills in application of this theoretical knowledge into practice. Then inculcating a disciplined attitude. You have to develop an attitude where you are disciplined. Imbibing due to professional orientation. So the articleship is a journey toward becoming a professional from the student. So you have to make your orientation toward profession, developing ethical values. being a student, you learn as an article trainee, you learn what are the ethical values of the TA profession. Then you need to develop your ethical values and live the all the effect, live these ethical values during day-to-day life, like maintaining confidentiality of client data, etc. So you need to learn effectively and live during your articleship. This topic is also very important, maintaining record of your learning. So whatever work you are during your articleship, an article assistant should maintain the detail of work undertaken and training received. So you can record your training in a way, how much time you have put in accounting, how much time you have put in auditing, how much time you have spent in taxation work, how much time you have worked on any software improving your information technology, and how much you have learned during related to management consultancy and other services. So during your articleship, you learn various items. You should keep a record of your learning, which is required as well as will help you in assess your performance at a later stage. So on a periodic basis, you can sit with your principal and discuss what areas you have learned during your articleship, in which areas you can now move and focus for your remaining period of articleship. So you can acquire multiple skills. So with that, I would be moving to the very important message for the student, that articleship during the course of chartered accountancy is extremely important, and it forms the backbone of your career. A qualified chartered accountant without articleship experience is just a blunt knife which has been built to cut anything but does not have enough strength. So this articleship period is sharpening your skills, sharpening the axe. So you can use this, all the strength or the skills acquired during your articleship, in practical implementation during your professional journey. I would also call this articleship period as launchpad for your career. So when you, from a student, when you become a professional, so your articleship period will work, your articleship experience will work as a launchpad. Better you learn during your articleship, you will be ahead from others or your peers. So whoever is doing work hard and acquiring all the professional and personal skills during this articleship period will help them in their professional journey. Either they go for practice or they join any organization. Apart from that, it is important that articleship should be seen as a tool to learn and grow whilst in the process of journey to become a chartered accountant. So it's a journey to become chartered accountant. It is very important that you do your articleship with diligence and seriously, and acquire all the professional and interpersonal skills from your practical exposure, and you practice it as well. With this, I would complete my deliberation and request Divya ji, if she has some queries or questions from various articles, we can discuss. Divya ji, can you hear me?
Yes, sir, I'm hearing you. We have questions, various questions from various students.
Okay.
So we have questions from students.
Okay.
Yes, sir. We have question from Samayak Chan. His question is, if someone does articleship from very small firm, because he is might, okay. whether he might not be able to crack interview in good firm, his career will end, or else what kind of problem he will get after qualifying CA despite all levels cleared in first attempt?
So, Samaya, you need to understand that working with a small firm is not important. You need, your article should be diligently done, because when you are undergoing through a training, it is important that you learn. When you are as a fresher chartered accountant interviewed in any organization, you are not expected to be expert of anything. But the skills that are interviewed by any employer are their interpersonal skills. So you need to focus on your learning and not to focus on small or big clients. So the exposure will be different, obviously, but you need to focus on what you are learning. You need to focus and learn it diligently and learn in detail. So if someone asks you what you have done, so you need to answer that what actually you have done and what you have learned out of it. So the focus should be on learning, and it doesn't make any difference that you are working in a smaller firm or a bigger firm. So just to give a perspective, I have done my articleship from a small firm in Jaipur, and my first job was with one of the big four firm in Delhi. So I am the example in front of you. You can confidently do your articleship and focus on your learning. It's not a problem at all.
So then we have next question from Ashwani Tatsurukale. His question is, can industrial training be done in banks? If yes, then what is the process criteria, and in which banks we can do industrial training?
All the industrial training, the list of industrial training, all the institute which are the industry who can you can go for industrial training is available on institute website. During our presentation, we have shared that how you can go to the link and you can download that list. So if in the dark list, the name of the institute is available, you can obviously go and do your training. So you need to go through the list. All the recognized institute or the bank or financial institution names are available in that list.
So then we have similar questions from Priyanshu Ladha, Gurijwala Shivani and Arpit Kedia. Their questions are, what type of work do we do in industrial training, unlike in firms? And are studies affected due to industrial training? And which industry to join? And when to start industrial training?
So as per regulation, the industrial training can be done into the last year, which is the third year of your articleship. It can be 9 months to 12 months, depending upon when you are applying for the training. So which industry to join will depend your career prospectus, your interest. So if you have identified your interest during your 2 years of period, I think, or you have identified some emerging areas, you can choose that industry and apply with the relevant industries for the industrial training.
So we have question from Shruti Nitin Pandey. Her question is, will we get good exposure for auditing in mid-sized firm as compared to big four? And will lockdown affect articleship training for students who will apply after July 2020 attempt?
So lockdown is impacting everyone, but we need to find the ways to learn things. So now it is a digital era. We are doing this a webinar as well online. Previously, we were doing all these things through a student conference. So I think it is a time when we need to learn the effective ways of digital learning, how we interact with people digitally, how we can so in during your articleship, you can during this lockdown, you can more focus on your theoretical knowledge, because the interaction with people is difficult. So we need to find out ways of digital working, and that will surely help on the question of will this articleship period will be impacted by COVID or not. You need to check with branch officials. I am not aware with this.
Okay, sir, we have question from Bhargav Sai Prasad. His question is, sir, what to do if an article wants to go for industrial training but principal is not allowing, even after intimating principal about the same well before 3 months as per ICI rules? Please help and guide in this matter.
I think you can go to the institute. You can write to the institute. That's the apex body who is which is governing us.
We have question from Khushbu Jain. Her question is, what is the scope of industrial training after becoming CA? Can industrial training be done after becoming CA? And which is the best place, city, etc.?
So, this industrial training can be done in last year of your articleship. So, once your articleship period is over, it is not industrial training which is required by ICI. You can join them as management trainee, etc. But you will the industrial training can be done only for last year of the articleship period only.
Okay, sir, we have question from Manisha. Her question is, sir, industrial training from 9 months period served is including or excluding HSC?
Your voice is not audible. Can you please repeat?
Okay, I repeat. Now my voice is audible.
Yeah.
This is a question. This is question from Manisha. Her question is, in industrial training, minimum 9 months of period is served. This 9 months period is including or excluding the leave?
This period is including of leave, which are allowed over a period of 3 years. So whatever overall leaves are allowed during a three years time can be availed during this industrial training period as well.
Okay, sir. We have question from Karthik Kabra. His question is the decision for allowing to register ourselves for industrial training depends on the firm under which we are doing our articleship?
Allowing for industrial training is under the ICI guidelines. Once you apply and select it, that procedure is well defined. You can refer to ICI website for all the details about that.
We have question from Yash Agarwal. His question is, how articles should manage studies when he is going through industrial training? How to manage both studies and industrial training?
So when you join industrial training, you have to be abide by the rules and regulations of the organization where you are working. So you need to learn the time management skill and all other skills we have already discussed, that you need to learn interpersonal skills which is required to work in a organization. So you need to manage your articles during your 2 years period. You have learned your skills and it is time for application of these skills, which will help you in managing your studies along with your industrial training.
Sir, again, we have questions from Yash Agarwal. His question is, if an article is choosing audit during articleship, will opportunity to pursue any other field or start practicing after qualifying CA will be available?
Yes, it is surely available. Again, I repeat that your articleship period is to learn things. You need to start on the process of learning. So it is not expected from a fresh chartered accountant to be expert of anything. एज ए फ्रेशर यू आर यू द प्रोसेस ऑफ लर्निंग शुड बी स्ट्रांग. यू कैन मूव टू एनी अदर पीरियड वेयर यूर वांट इफ यू योर यू हैव डेवलप्ड द स्किल्स विच आर रिक्वायर्ड फॉर प्रोफेशन विच वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन डिटेल इन आर वेबकास्ट.
So then we have, am I audible? We have another question from Manisha. A question is, my industrial training period is 10 months, 27 days. And in this, I took 4 months leave. So please tell me excess period of leave. Can I serve excess period in another CA firm? Or is it mandatory to serve that period in the same organization? Please tell me if I'm eligible to file form 105 form after taking that leave.
This is very specific case. I think she needs to reach out to the branch for this discussion. Divyaji, I am not getting response from you.
Hello, am I audible?
Yeah, now you are audible.
Yeah, we have next question from Purva Jain. Her question is it worth shifting your attempt for industrial training? Hemant sir, can you hear me?
Yeah, can you please repeat your question?
Yeah, this is a question from Purva Jain. Her question is, it worth shifting your attempt for industrial training?
It is quite a personal choice that if you are not prepared, then you can do that. Otherwise, if you are well prepared and you are able to manage, you should take your attempt on time only.
Yes, and now it's coming. Sir, we have a question from Smriti Goyal. Her question is, sir, should we go to firm giving overall knowledge of each subject or in a firm having a particular field of a subject in practice for specialization?
So again, this is a matter of choice. Again, I will emphasize that the period of articleship is for your learning. So your focus should be on learning. If it will be a completely personal choice, if somebody has identified his area of interest for his professional life, he can go and do the work with a specialized firm or in the area of a specialization. But if somebody is not sure and he wants to pursue his career and he wants to explore the opportunities or his interest, then I think it is better to work with a multidisciplinary firm.
Then we have a question from Shikhar Shivastav. His question is there any necessity of articleship oblique industrial training if you want to go in for teaching profession after CA?
So, to be eligible for CA final exams, you have to complete your articleship. So, are you going for any other profession, you are into practice or not, doesn't matter. You have to complete your articleship to a certain period of your articleship to sit in your exam. And after qualifying your exams to get the degree, you also have to complete your articleship training. and submit the relevant documents to the institute.
Sir, almost all of the questions have been answered. And am I audible to you?
Yes, yes.
So most of the questions of the students have answered. I'm sure they must be satisfied with their queries. So thank you very much, sir, for your wonderful and eye-opening words of wisdom about CA articleship and industrial training. And I believe every student attending this session must have learned some important things and made a value addition in their knowledge. Friends, in this skill enrichment program, we had three sessions which were conducted in the last week, and three sessions will be conducted in this week. Today was one session on 22nd and on 23rd and 24th May, and two sessions will be next week on 29th and 30th May. Tomorrow we will have session on overseas opportunities for CA and CA students with learned speaker CA Ganesh Sharma from Canada. And day after tomorrow, we will have a session of learning to get success beyond dreams with Dheeraj Sharma ji from Gurgaon. So stay tuned with ICI and learn more. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you very much.